Okay, so today we are going to look at a new browser from the browser company called Dia. So, just as a quick demo, I am looking at an article here, and let's say I don't have time to read this. I want to summarize it. I go up here, I say, summarize this article in 3 bullet points. And in a couple seconds, I'm going to have a summary of the article, right? So, boom, there we go. Summarize the thing, and I can keep chatting with it. I can actually go into live mode if I want to talk like in real time with it. Pretty cool. Except, of course, this is not Dia. This is Chrome. This is the current version, the stable version of Chrome that has Gemini built in that lets you do things on websites to analyze them. Like, here's another one. Write a quick email to a friend, telling them about this. Cool. And so now we're drafting an email to a friend, and there you go. Didn't include a link. Include a link. Cool. So it should do this. I don't know why you would have it draft an email for you, but I'm basing this partially on how the browser company has advertised Dia. So here we go. So here's the thing, and then I could, copy to my clipboard and then paste it into an email. So that's Chrome. That's what Chrome is doing. Let's go ahead and hide this and let's pull up. I've got all the browsers here. Let's pull up Dia. Same exact page. How does it work here? So in Dia, Dia is the new browser from the people who made Arc, and a browser that I really, really loved, but they didn't for reasons. And same article, kind of doing its thing, and I can hit chat here. Also, a nice thing, you can hit Command E on a web page, and it just pulls up the chat window over here. And I could say, summarize this in 3 bullet points. Cool. And it's going to do exactly the same thing. It's basically a browser plugin, right? That's built into the browser. Turn this into a short, friendly email to a friend. Make sure to include the link. Okay, and so now it's drafting an email that I can copy into wherever. Here's this interesting article, here's the link. Okay, and then I can copy it to my clipboard as well. So, okay, that's something. That's pretty much it. I've basically shown you all the features of Dia. The weird thing about Dia, which again is replacing Arc, which was a full-featured, very unbelievably good browser, that's really it. We can start a new chat if we want. We can close this. If we select something, does this help? Ask Dia about this. Okay. So that enters some text. Translate this into French. Okay, you can see by the quality of these demos that I'm really struggling to find a real use case for this. I think the interesting thing, the only potentially interesting thing about Dia is basically let's just open a new tab. You're going to notice that if you, one of the things that drew you to Arc or Xen, which I currently use as my main browser, was like the side tabs. You don't get that in Dia. Dia is just the classic Chrome style Windows, which is fine. Most people seem to prefer that, but a bummer for someone like me. The interesting thing potentially is that when you open a new tab, you get this view, which is a search field. So you could do Birchtree and search for that. Just does a Google search, right? That actually shows my current location, which I don't need to do. So I'll blur out most of that. You can see your bookmarks here. You'll notice that when I go into a bookmark, the bookmark bar disappears. It would like to use my microphone. I have no idea what triggered the microphone. I'll just say yes, because eventually I will, maybe. But yeah, the bookmark bar is always hidden. There's no way to show it. If you like seeing your bookmarks, you can't do that. There's only the bookmark bar. There's no like other like it's very, very simple how this works. So anyway, the cool thing, I promise to show the cool thing. The cool thing is you can at mention things. So I have these three tabs open, which are reports I generated using Google's deep research, Gemini's deep research thing. And this is showing me a bunch of little things about different areas of payments, right? Chargeback stuff, buy now, pay later, and network tokens. And so maybe I wanted to, maybe I'm someone who wants to build a product and is using these as my inspiration. So let's say I'm a PM who wants to build a new product that addresses the needs of merchants around these topics. And then I can at, and I could say all tabs, or I can choose individual ones. I'll do all tabs just because it's easier to add them all and then remove the ones I don't need. So there's my three large Google Docs. Start a chat. I think this will take a minute to process because these are relatively large docs. And it's going to tell me something about them, right? It's passing in the contents of those web pages into the LLM, and it's doing things with them, which is fine. And you can do that with ChatGPT and Gemini and Claude already. Like, I think the difference here is I would have to export these as PDFs, and then I would have to upload them into those apps. So it is a little bit more friction. It is kind of nice to be able to just kind of like reference them here. You may have noticed while it's thinking, you may have noticed in Chrome, I have those same reports pulled up here. But if I pull up the Gemini thing, I have to make a new chat here. It's sharing this one page, but I can't find a way to add more context. So I can get it to summarize the main features I might want to build around this. It'll ask this question about the current tab that I'm looking at, but I can't figure out how to get it to look at multiple tabs. So I can't do it all at once. So if I have multiple documents, it's not really going to work. If we go over to Dia, okay, Dia has done its thing. So it's, you know, it's passed them all into an LLM, and it's given me recommendations, right? And that's kind of what you would expect. What model are you? So just if you were curious, it is running on GPT. API, so one of the GPT-4. I've tried to poke it in Prada to give me more info, but it won't tell me more about like its custom prompt or anything. But yeah, it's an LLM. It's the ChatGPT interface. That's pretty much it. I think the innovation here is that you can at mention, again, you can at mention things that you're doing, that you're looking at in your browser, and you can kind of do multiple at the same time. Again, Chrome already has this. For one tab at a time, Dia lets you do multiple tabs. So that's something. Why did this happen? I love Arc. Arc is a really great browser. If I go over here, like I'm a huge fan of Arc. And what kills me about Arc kind of is like, I've got these documents pulled up here. Here's a news article. And it's like the summarize thing, summarize this. Arc had this feature. Like, it's the same thing. And it actually had something interesting where it would like cite different parts of the page you were on, and you would be able to go to it and like see that part of the article, which could be helpful. Quote not found. Interesting. The LLM made that one up. Lovely. Yeah, like it already had this sort of thing. I could do the same thing here. I think Google is going to, Google takes over the command F. So let me go into edit, find, cool. What are three features I could build into my merchant app based on this, right? And so it's the exact same thing, right? These are not as good of answers, but like the interface was here, this idea that you could, and this was like a really clever thing, right? I would like we do control F on a page, and it could be like tariff, and it was a normal control F, but like if you type something that wasn't found on the page, like what are tariffs, then it would let you go into this like LLM mode, right? And so that was fine, whatever. I didn't use that a ton. But what made Arc really great was it just felt good to use. It was a really nice app, and it just had great keyboard shortcuts, and it introduced my favorite control or command shift C to copy the current URL, which is now, I think, a standard feature everything should have. And basically, here's an article they just posted a couple days ago about kind of why they made the change. And I'll put a link in the description if you want to read it. But let's just say I'm not super impressed by it. I think they're chasing they're trying to be too big. They're trying to be like the next biggest company in the world. And yeah, what's interesting is in this article where they talk about like some of the features that they liked or that were cool in Arc, but like very few people used. By contrast, core features in Dia, like chatting with tabs and personalization features, are used by 40% and 37% of daily active users, respectively. This is the kind of clarity and immediate value we're working toward. So they're saying these features weren't useful in Arc because almost nobody used them, but these features are very good. Like lots of people are using them in Dia. And that's okay, except that's literally the only feature that they have. They don't have any other features besides this chat thing. So if 60 to 63% of their users are not using the literal only thing that this browser has, that's not great. And I say that kind of in jest, but like literally there is no other features. This is a stripped down Chromium browser with a nice UI. Like their UI designers are world class. Like Arc was fantastic. This is really good as well. They've got nice animations, but like this is the entire customization. The entire reason you would use Dia is for this chat interface. And most people apparently aren't even using it, which is crazy to me. So yeah, that's really all I have to say about that. I continue to use Xen. I think Xen is really good. I wish that the Firefox rendering engine would be more reliable. There are definitely issues here, even more than I get with Safari, which is kind of crazy. But all my extensions work. I can customize the UI. It's very full featured. And if I want some of those AI features, there's tons of extensions I can install to get those in the browser. So yeah, I think the chatting thing with your multiple tabs is kind of cool, but I really struggled to find a real life use case that worked for me. So I don't know. We'll see if this turns into something. We'll see in the future, but for now, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching today. This is the season finale of A Better Computer. I'm going to take the summer off like I normally do. I'll post a video too here or there, but yeah, welcome. I'll look forward to seeing you guys in the fall when season 4 kicks off, hopefully with some really cool stuff to show. So thank you so much. Bye-bye.